Hi people, Mohinur Ehimbakir again. This is going to be a really quick video. And as the header states, I'm simply going to discuss really quick why some people see spirits and others don't, generally speaking, or why some people never even come close to coming into contact with anything of an occult nature, despite going to locations where occult activity or astral activity or spiritual activity is heavy. Long story short, it's simply, as we all know, people are different. Some people are more, how should I put it, not vulnerable. Some people are more approachable than others, astrally speaking. You have people that go to graveyards and locations that are haunted and they never experience a single thing. And then again, you've got others that, that don't even go near these locations and they regularly come into contact with spiritual entities, whether it be for in a good way, a positive way, or a negative way. The reason, plain and simply, is that susceptibility. Yeah, that's what I was going for. Susceptibility. The thing is, like I said, people are different. Some people are more susceptible than others. And the people that aren't susceptible are people, generally speaking, that are superficial. People that are very agnostic or atheistic and that have no interest from the bottom of their heart in religion or anything of a religious nature whatsoever. And that's on the one hand. On the other hand, some people are simply that superficial, and for them, the material world or the material plane is all that exists to them. They're that ignorant and that, period. And that oblivious, yeah, that's what I was going for. They're that oblivious to existence as a whole. And they're just so mired in superficiality that for them, all they care about is things like making money and so on. They only care about the superficial and about the material, therefore. Just ignore the barking in the background. And the reason why, and even if it's someone that has a heavy interest in the occult, but that person never comes into contact with any spiritual activity or experiences anything along those lines, all the three examples that I mentioned, and just straight up for whatever reason, people in general that find themselves, whether they want to or not being able to come into contact with any occult force, regardless of whether they actively or deliberately try to do so or not, the reason is plain and simple, like I said, susceptibility. Again, susceptibility. Spirits. Some people appeal to spirits, whereas others don't. And it is complicated to explain, but point is that spirits are not going to approach someone or try to mess with someone or come into contact with someone who, generally speaking, meets the criteria or who has the traits that I described just now. Someone that's superficial, someone that only cares about the material, and it just goes on and so forth. Whereas someone that has an active interest in occultism and someone that has a certain level or possesses a certain level of clairvoyance will, generally speaking, get attention from spirits because these spirits see that that person is reachable, that person is approachable, whether it's in a positive way or a negative way. Keep in mind that this is in general. There are exceptions of people that don't believe in spirits and anything like that. People that are completely atheistic and agnostic, and yet they still come across a life-changing event, something that they couldn't explain. In any case, something of a spiritual or occult nature. But these are exclusions. These are highly exceptional people and highly exceptional scenarios and cases. I'm just going to ignore that. So what I'm saying accounts for this topic in general, or this subject in general. Like I said, it's about the fact that some people are approachable towards spirits and others simply aren't. Okay, I'm going to give an example. That's the best way I can explain it. It's like you, for example, asking yourself why spirits don't communicate with every person on Earth, or they don't communicate with the vast majority of people on Earth in general. It's the same reason as if someone were to ask you, why don't you carry on a discussion with a boulder? That's what a person that has no occult interest and that is so underdeveloped or not developed at all on a spiritual level, someone that's ridiculously superficial, someone that doesn't care, that doesn't even think twice about the afterlife or anything like that. That's what someone like that is to a spirit. That spirit sees you like a boulder. And it's the same asking yourself that question, why don't spirits communicate with all people in general, is like asking yourself, why don't I communicate with inanimate objects like a boulder, a rock, or a piece of wood? Why don't you do that, literally? The reason is plain and simple, because they're inanimate objects. They don't show any signs of life whatsoever, let alone any sign of consciousness. So generally speaking, you're just going to ignore it. You're going to say, I'd be insane because I'm not going to get any feedback whatsoever from a boulder. I'm not going to talk to something inanimate. That's what I'm talking about. It's the same thing for a spirit. A spirit won't appeal to a spirit if you're like these people, because spirits already dislike people in general, because we inhabit in the material plane, we inhabit the lowest of planes, pretty much one of the lowest of planes at the very least. That is the material plane. And if for spirits, especially celestial spirits like angels and so on, heavenly spirits or spirits that are holy and divine, to these spirits, it's like conversing with a human being or socializing with a person. It's like going to the worst neighborhood in town and communicating with that person. They'll only do it if they have something to gain, if there is something in it for them. The same reason that if you live in the nicest part of town, you're not going to go to some remote ghetto which is filled with nothing but crime and negativity and misery, unless you have a specific reason, a specific motive for doing so. It's the same thing for them. I mean, I, for example, am not going to communicate with someone that is so stupid and so ignorant that person doesn't even know what occultism means. You know, I mean, even if someone consciously asks me, the second I notice that person is that stupid, I'm just going to say, nah, never mind. I'm not even going to bother. It's the same thing with spirits. To spirits, someone that's so super, that is that superficial, is like a boulder. And that spirits are going to say, I'm not even going to bother. Whereas someone like me, for example, I'm ridiculously well-developed, even if I say so myself, spiritually. And I have always, it's simply a character trait of mine, I've always had a high level of clairvoyance, but the difference is that it was dormant before I became an occultist. But bottom line is that I always had that heavy affinity, and I always drew spirits to me. And the reason that spirits approached me, unfortunately in my case, it was negative. You know, they always tried to bother me or pester me or anything like that in most cases. But the point is that I appealed to these spirits because these spirits saw me, and they saw that, you know, I was actually going to pay attention to them. I was going to notice them because I'm developed enough spiritually and I possess a certain degree or level of consciousness to the point where it's actually worth it. Whereas with someone that is actually as stupid as a doorknob, you know, spirits are going to say, yeah, I'm not even going to bother. Well, what good will come of it? Generally speaking, that's the attitude that spirits have. That's something to keep in mind. And that's why some people see spirits and others don't. Some people go to graveyards, all hell breaks loose, they see every person that was buried at that graveyard and more. And other people, they can sleep on graveyards day in, day out, etc., etc. They can go to the most haunted locations on earth, and they're not really going to notice anything, and they're not, you know, they're not going to see anything, and they're going to dub it superstition. That's what people like that generally do, because they automatically assume that their situation is the only tangible situation conceivable. But yeah, that's it in any case. So basically, people like that aren't worth spirits their time. Spirits look at that person and they're like, you know, it's like a boulder to them. They're like, just ignore the piece of crap, you know, ignore them. You can see what kind of person it is. Whereas someone that's well-developed is definitely someone that's worth their time. Again, I'm referring back to the example. It's for the same reason that we as human beings don't converse with animals in general, because we know that animals don't have the level of, it's like conversing with an ant. An ant doesn't possess the level of consciousness we as human beings do, to the point where you can carry on a serious discussion about mankind and civilization, etc., etc., and everything in existence. Now, we as human beings are amongst mammals and other animals, so the most well-developed, if you want to say it like that. Species-wise, we're one of the most developed spiritually. So that's why it makes no sense or to converse with an ant unless you want to be seen as insane. It's the same thing. Okay, spirits already dislike people. You know, spirits will, generally speaking, take an interest in people if there's something in it for them, and or if that person is worth their time, if that person is spiritually developed enough or ascendant enough to the point where it's actually worth their time, to the point where there's a, you know, that spirit sees that you possess a certain level of consciousness, to the point where you're actually worth his trouble, his or her or its trouble. But spirits aren't going to bother with some oaf that doesn't even, that literally can't even count to 10, so to speak. So they're not even going to bother. They're going to just straight up ignore you. Again, there are exceptional cases, like I said, but generally speaking, that's it. So yeah, that's all. Bye.